Good morning. Please be seated. Welcome to the A.T. Still University, Arizona School of Health Sciences, Class of 2022 Commencement Ceremony. I'm Dr. Norman Gevitz, Senior Vice President of Academic Affairs for ATSU. This is a very special day in the lives of those receiving degrees from A.T. Still University. Family and friends, on behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration, thank you for joining us in honoring these outstanding graduates and recognizing their great achievement. Graduates, you now have the tools and capacity to make a difference in your communities and in the lives of the people you serve. The degree each of you will receive today is not just a credential. It is a testament to your proficiency and competency in mastering a range of difficult subjects. Congratulations, we are proud of you. We wish you the best, and we look forward to hearing from you as you go forward to improve the well-being of all communities. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as you are able for the national anthem.
Please be seated. Good morning. I'm Dr. Ann Lee Birch, Dean of the Arizona School of Health Sciences. It is my honor to introduce the stage party. Please do hold your applause until the end. Starting on my right, Dr. Craig Phelps, class of 1984, Kirksville College of Osteopathic Medicine, and president of A.T. Still University. Dr. Norman Gevitz, Senior Vice President of Academic Affairs for A.T. Still University. Dr. Gary Cloud, Vice President of Strategic University Partnerships. Dr. Michelle DeBase, Professor and Chair of Physician Assistant Studies. Dr. Angela Kaselik, Assistant Professor and Marshal for Physician Assistant Studies. Dr. Kim DeVore-Kochanoff, Assistant Professor in the Department of Physician Assistant Studies, and Dr. Ray Pavlik, Professor in the Department of Physician Assistant Studies. And on my left, Dr. Catherine Alicia Georges, today's commencement speaker and honorary degree recipient. Dr. Marlene Salas-Provence, Vice Dean and Professor for the Arizona School of Health Sciences. Clinton Normore, Vice President of Diversity and Inclusion. Dr. Thomas Hartman, Physician Assistant Studies, Class of 2008, and Arizona School of Health Sciences Alumni Association Representative. And seated on the stage is the amazing Arizona School of Health Sciences PA faculty. Please give them a big round of applause. Would any graduates, guests, or faculty who are current or retired members of the uniformed services or first responders please stand? Thank you for all you do for our communities and country. I would also like to recognize friends and family in the audience this morning who have supported the graduates on their journey. Please give them a big round of applause. Graduating class of 2022, today I stand with the Arizona School of Health Sciences physician assistant faculty and staff in celebration of you. This is a day of new beginnings, of joy, pride, and hope. Graduates, you are quite possibly entering one of the most vibrant times of your life, where your skills and humanity have never been more needed in communities across the country and around the world. We celebrate your graduation from ATSU today as you exemplify all that we believe in: whole person healthcare, commitment to the underserved, educational excellence, and community. The first thing that comes to mind when I think about physician assistants, students, faculty, clinicians, leaders, is what strong advocates you are. Advocating for your patients, underserved communities, one another, the profession itself, with a steely, committed resolve and an emphasis on how you can heal others. All of you before me have accomplished so much in the last 2 years and 2 months, completing an intense and rigorous course of study, having both the privilege and the tenacity to serve in the nation's community health centers and hospitals. You persevered in a whirlwind period for the country and the world as the pandemic escalated and de-escalated and changed the landscapes of education and healthcare. All of you arrived here with vastly different trajectories as your stories. You saw the scope of opportunity for pursuing your PA degree. You seized that opportunity, worked so hard to get here, and succeeded during an era of rapid change. The most meaningful achievements in life grow from the type of hard work and commitment you've grown accustomed to. You have brought to ATSU your diversity. You have brought us your voices as students, your ideas, your recommendations, and opinions. This diversity among us continues to enrich our learning culture and is so crucial to the effectiveness of care in our communities. Class of 2022, you will take your new knowledge, skill, critical inquiry, professionalism, and that steady commitment to compassion and integrity and continue to make a difference in the lives of so many. Throughout your professional lives, keep listening to your patients, your mentors, professions outside of your own, your colleagues, your friends, and family. For those very challenging days, find your stride, walk steady, and finally, stay curious, committed, true to who you are and where you have come from, and you will leap over any obstacles in your way and continue to find deep meaning and joy in the important work of bringing optimal health to individuals and communities. Congratulations. It is now my honor to present our honorary degree candidate and today's commencement speaker, Dr. Catherine Alicia Georges. A Doctor of Humane Letters is an honorary degree conferred by the university to those providing superior leadership and scholarly attainment in education, the arts, and humanities. Our speaker today very much fits that criterion. Dr. Catherine Alicia Georges, a professor and chairperson of the Department of Nursing at Lehman College, is a leader in academic nursing, health policy development, community engagement, organizational development, and healthy aging. Her leadership in these areas is known nationally and internationally through her service as a member of health policy boards, healthcare delivery boards, professional organizations, governmental boards, and the world's largest consumer organization board of directors. She is committed to assuring social justice and equity for marginalized and vulnerable communities. Dr. Georges served as the National Volunteer President of AARP. AARP is the world's largest consumer organization. She served as the fifth president of the National Black Nurses Association and is the president of the National Black Nurses Foundation. She is a lifetime member of the National Black Nurses Association. Dr. Georges is a fellow of the New York Academy of Medicine and the American Academy of Nursing. In 2019, she was named a living legend by the American Academy of Nursing. In 2020, she was named most distinguished alumna of Seton Hall University. And in 2021, the American Academy of Nursing named her as its 2021 Lifetime Legacy Awardee. Dr. Georges was elected the chair of the National Easter Seals Board in October 2021, and she is the first black female volunteer to serve in that role. Dr. Georges received a Bachelor of Science in Nursing degree from Seton Hall University College of Nursing, a Master's of Arts degree in Community Health Nursing Administration, and supervision from NYU New York University School of Education, and a doctorate in Educational Leadership and Policy Studies from the University of Vermont. President Phelps and Dr. Georges, please join me at the podium. President Phelps, it is my honor and privilege to present to you Catherine Georges for the honorary degree, Doctor of Humane Letters.
One of the highest degrees AT Still University of Health Sciences may confer is an honorary doctoral degree in recognition of superior commitment to osteopathic principles and for service to healthcare, medical education, scientific research, community service and leadership in political or educational administration. Dr. Georges, upon the recommendation of the faculty dean and senior vice president of academic affairs, and by the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon you the degree, Doctor of Humane Letters, with all the rights, honors, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
President Phelps, Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, also known as Provost, Dr. Kravets, Dean Ann Lieberg, Chair of the PA Program, Dr. DeBassi, faculty, staff members, significant others, and friends of the graduates, and most of all, to you, the class of 2022. Good morning. Thank you for giving me this honorary degree. I am humbled and thankful for your consideration, and I consider this an honor. Congratulations to all the graduates on your wonderful accomplishment. You should be proud of the history of this university, founded in 1892 by Dr. Andrew Taylor Still. The reputation of this university as a multidisciplinary health education and also research institution has impacted the delivery of health services throughout this country. The holistic approach to individualized healthcare and care to communities, a tenant on which this university has been built. It is in the spirit of these tenets that permeates your curricula that I address you today. We are living in a VUCA environment. If you don't know, that means a volatile, an uncertain, a complex, and ambiguous environment. In the past 26 months, we face an unfathomable event, the COVID-19 virus. The world changed and continues to change every day because of this virulent virus. Our economy has been on a roller coaster, as evidenced by the daily stock market results. I've decided I'm not looking at them anymore. But I say to you today, do not be daunted, because we were faced with this disease and the economic disruptions and violence in parts of the country and the horrors of climate change. You've chosen a profession where you will touch people's lives in such a profoundly positive way because of your preparation here at A.T. Steele University and your commitment to building healthy people and healthy communities. You will and must be part of a critical healthcare field undergoing considerable change because of this pandemic and the effects of the economic downturn in our country. Now, I can't tell you exactly how this will shake out in the next 10 years or even in the next year or two. But I think there are some fundamental truths we can be confident about that will shape your work and the future of healthcare. One is demographic. Another is the influence of social determinants of health. And the third truth is the critical role of primary care providers such as yourselves, a role that I deeply believe has become increasingly important in this country. And just as an example, the other day the New York Times indicated that in New York City, more than 50% of the primary care providers were non-physicians. They were PAs and nurse practitioners. So let's start with a demographic change. Every day, 10,000 people in this country turn 65. By 2030, one in five Americans will be 65 or older. By that time, we might have 1 million people who are aged 100 or older. Our fastest growing age group is comprised of those over 85. We already know from data from around the globe that a person who will live to be 150 years old has already been born. People want to age with dignity and purpose, and the overwhelming majority of them want to age at home. As we reflect on longer lifespans, we need to focus intensely on longer health spans. Later years in which we're in relatively good health, able to keep working if we want to, and able to enjoy the gift of time. Many people who are older are having the time of their lives. I am. Many more could be. How we have managed the pandemic, however, and its effects on the older population in this country are lessons learned for the future. We have to recognize and address the glaring health disparities driven by long-standing social determinants that exists across ethnic, racial, socioeconomic, and geographical lines, often in defiance of more promising trends in the population as a whole. The COVID-19 brought this once again to the surface. And if you read the latest data from the CDC of life expectancy in the United States, it's gone down for all of us, but worse for people from Hispanic or Latinx populations and African Americans. Social determinants of health, which includes areas such as homelessness, poverty, food insecurity, education, and social isolation, have once again intersected. Some communities are plagued by violence from its own residents, as well as from those who should be protecting our communities. The death of George Floyd showed us this. Social isolation, we thought, only occurred where those who were older or lacked access became commonplace. I know I didn't leave my house for almost 3 months. As the pandemic abated in some places, we saw a decrease in the social isolation. But we must make sure that social determinants of health are a central part of the debate and the decisions about improving healthcare. As healthcare professionals, we must be adept at addressing the critical questions concerning these social determinants. We and the team we work with in all our settings should raise questions such as, will this family or patient need long-term care? Will they need nutrition services? Do they have the supports they need at home? Are they isolated? Are they depressed? Are there family dynamics that may have a negative impact on their health? Why is the patient missing the appointments that you have set up? Is the sky-high cost of prescription drugs forcing the patient to choose between paying for a prescription or paying for groceries or rent or utilities? That was the last commercial I saw this morning on the TV in my room about the cost of prescription drugs around here in Arizona. You will have a vital role in making sure we acknowledge and address social determinants. You will be crucial to meeting the healthcare challenges of an aging population as you provide transitional care, help to reduce rehospitalization, inform and support America's 40 million family caregivers, and provide care coordination, chronic disease management, and preventive care that you've learned well here at this university. Healthcare is increasingly being provided in non-traditional settings. So I know you folks have become experts in telemedicine and telehealth. As I think about the many key contributions you can make, you must speak out about the conscious and unconscious bias that has crept into our society's healthcare system. In many parts of our country, your zip code becomes the manner in which you are treated. We call it health disparity by location, and in many instances, because of one's race and ethnicity. Making automatic assumptions about patients is antithetical to good health care. The scope of your contribution will reflect your capacity for recognizing the individuality of every patient and truly listening, the tenets on which this curricula were built. So listening, in my view, is the most underrepresented skill, and it's a skill that we must refine through practice. The ability to keep a clear head under pressure, understanding the principles and the value of teamwork, the capacity to provide comprehensible, jargon-free explanations is greatly needed by families, patients, and communities. A closer view and insights into problems your patients face and could be facing in the future is important for you to address. As you think today about your new degree and where you're headed next, I'll ask you to consider for a moment, where will you be in a few years? The skills and experience you will have, and how you can put those assets to work in different arenas. So I urge you in your careers to share your perspective, to look for opportunities for leadership, to find a place at the table where policies are set. No seats, bring your own chair. Your door closed, open it. You know, I urge you to use your voice. You as physicians, assistants, will be pivotal to creating a culture of health in our country, a culture that embraces prevention as well as treatment, a culture that seeks to shed biases and rid the country of the chronic disease of racism. You must create a culture that meets head-on external factors that produce such inequitable outcomes. So to truly exercise that pivotal role, you must use your voice. Our communities and our country need to hear your voices, not only in the hospital and in community health centers and in other health delivery systems, but we need you folks in boardrooms. We need you in the committee rooms. We need you in legislative chambers, places where budgets and decisions and policies are made. We need to hear you on the social determinants of health. Maybe someday you'll even take on an entrepreneurial role, putting together a business with some of your other colleagues. After all, the portended considerations and consolidations and other structural changes that are inevitable now and after this pandemic is finally over, we know there will be new models of care that affect hospitals, doctors, and the rest of us who are healthcare professionals. You can shape what can be. In my case, and I suspect in others, not every new role is an instant fit. Not every step in a new path is smooth. Not every answer is readily apparent. Not every opinion you offer is greeted with applause. I wish my faculty would greet me with applause when I give my opinion, but they don't. But anyway, being resilient and having a sense of humor about life and about yourself are indispensable. You gotta smile, you gotta laugh, you gotta loosen up. Taking on a leadership role can be daunting, but probably easier than the challenges you had with a curricula here at ATSU. You must use your knowledge and you must use your voice. You must speak out about the erosion of rights of persons here in the United States. You must use your voice to get the United States Congress to now address the issue of Social Security and Medicare. They kind of did it with prescription drugs. You must use your voice to get Congress to pass gun control. I may be in the wrong state, but I still say we need it in this country. You must use your voice to get Congress to pass equitable voting rights in this country. You must use your voice to get all that you know to get to the polls. And I don't care what party you belong to, you need to go to the polls. You must use your voice to encourage, influence, and support health professionals like yourselves to seek elected positions in their professional organizations, in their local, state, and national legislative bodies. When more and more of us are intimately involved in the delivery of health care and health services in this country, we will set in motion an unstoppable tsunami of change. With this degree in hand, you are setting your direction by a moral compass. But please remember, we must aim for collective action. We must work as a team with others in the health professions in reaching these goals. I want to leave you with the words of a poem by Maiha Stewart that I believe sums up what our strategy as a team should be and how we must use our voices to assure social justice and equity. So I urge you to act as one, to believe in each other, to commit to excellence, to do whatever it takes, but you must embrace a common vision. You must foster group intelligence, and you must give others the benefit of the doubt. You must harness the power of many, inspiring cooperation, not competition. But you also have to juggle the skills and the talents of others. You must kindle collaborative genius. You must always look out for each other. We must think more of the we and less of the me, not minding who gets the credit. We must overcome obstacles together, and we must put our principles before our personalities. And we must learn to quickly resolve our differences, recognizing each other's strength, also sharing the workload, but treat each other with respect, utilizing everyone's skill and valuing everybody's input. We must continue to work side by side, expecting exponential results, but we must yearn to succeed together, and then guess what? We will zestfully make a difference. Thanks for inviting me.
Thank you, Dr. Georges. Graduates, are you ready? It's now your turn. I know you are ready. So would the guest hooders please proceed to the stage at this time? In presenting the candidates for the Master of Physician Assistant Studies, Dr. Kim DeVore-Kochanoff will be assisted by Dr. Ray Pavlik and Dr. Linda McConnell. Would the Master of Science in Physician Assistant Studies, Class of 2022, please move to the stage.
Allison Abbey. Arlene Adams. Justin Andrews. Joshua, being hooded by Justin Andrews. Sydney Archuleta, being hooded by Tracy Archuleta. Cassandra R. Alvelo. Natasha Baraskas. Kaylee Bertrand. Jennifer Bergdorf. Haley Chapman. Jasmine Chaudhry. O'Shea Chaudhry. Marina Elena Chavez Siqueiros. Kelly Chang. Aaron Shishuski, being hooded by Melinda Rockcliffe. Abby Covillo. Kayla DeJesus, being hooded by Melinda Rockcliffe. Taylor Drummonds. Melissa Galloway. Erica Garcia. Sean Brandon Garcia. Rachel Goldstein. Erica Henderson. Kayla Hinton. Marina Holden. Logan Howard. Elaine Hu. Amber Ignacheski. Eileen Kilpatrick, being hooded by Stuart Richards. Garrett Kobayashi. Monica Kohler. Mario Lant. Jacob Layfield. Timothy Lay. Stella Lee. Corey Ann Lloyd, being hooded by Cammy Alexander. Grace Lowe. Megan Maddox. Sarah Maldonado. Stephanie Martins, being hooded by Tracy Archuleta. Lindsay K. McMinn. Leighton Medea Mendez. Soraya Merrick. Vivian Montes. Woo! Vivian Mundo. Cassidy Murray. Shalise Nelson. Shireen Nori. Jessica O'Neill. Angeles Olivares. Kyle Olson. Jessica Peterson. Dana Pizrick. Marley Pocasangre. Shay Preble. Madison Ramirez. Isabel Reback, being hooded by Robert Reback. Andrew Sawyer. Casey Christina Slaughter. Madison Sourwine. Lauren Stafford. Melissa Stasiak, being hooded by Brittany Halsey. Grace Stewart, being hooded by Eve Ashby. Natalie Stillwell. Jacqueline Sutter Padilla. Joel Swanner. Tamara Takemoto. Jenna Terrace. Matthew Volpe, being hooded by Clary Olensky. Sydney Fursenar. Elizabeth Watson, being hooded by Erica Watson. Chelsea White. Kristen Lee Wilson. Annalisa Wright, being guest-hooded by Sean Wright.
Gotta get on those weights. Take your time. It's only one of the most important minutes of your life. Just kidding. Please stand, graduates. That was great. Upon the recommendation of the faculty dean and senior vice president of academic affairs, and by the authority vested in me by the board of trustees and the state of Arizona, I hereby confer upon each of you the degree, Master of Science in Physician Assistant Studies, with all the rights, honors, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Give our graduates one more round of applause. Please be seated. Since 1892, ATSU-ASHS University has graduated almost 35,000 alumni. Today, we welcome you to our alumni family. Representing the Arizona School of Health Sciences alumni chapter is Dr. Thomas Hartman, Physician Assistant Studies, class of 2008.
Thank you, Dr. Birch. Good morning. Well, congratulations on the successful completion of your ATSU-ASHS University program of study at the Arizona School of Health Sciences. Okay, please stand for the formal induction into the alumni chapter, graduates. All right. As a member of the Arizona School of Health Sciences alumni chapter, and by the authority vested in me by the ATSU Alumni Association, it is my pleasure and privilege to formally induct you individually and as a graduating class into the membership of the Arizona School of Health Sciences Alumni Chapter. You may be seated.
Thank you, Dr. Hartman. As we conclude our commencement ceremony, I welcome President Phelps to the podium for his closing remarks.
Thank you, Dr. Birch. Dr. Georges, it was a pleasure hearing from you today. I followed your career and was so glad that you were able to come and spend some time with us and share some of the great opportunities and challenges facing our young graduates, our faculty, staff, our citizens in our country, and our world. So thank you very, very much. I want to thank the folks at the Mesa Arts Center. They always do a great job keeping this rowdy crowd under control, sort of. But they're great. They're always here and with a smile on their face and helping us out. Our student affairs staff, Michael Zajac and his team, putting this together along with the staff from ASHS and the PA program. Our vice presidents, our faculty and staff, just an amazing faculty in the PA program, our IT services, and all those folks that helped out today. They're across the university, and they get here early and stay late and clean up, and just want to make sure that they get their due, and thank you. But graduates, today is one of the most important days in your personal and professional life. So think about the number of graduates today, and think about, maybe the average will be about 3,000 patient visits a year, right? It's quick to do the math for each of you. The impact that you're going to have on society is truly, truly a tsunami. In several minutes, when you walk through those doors for the rest of your life, you will wear the mantle of a healer. More importantly, those sitting before you, next to you, and behind you will support and continue to support you throughout your career as you dedicate yourself to the most noble of all callings. You have what our nation needs, and in fact, what our world needs. As our founder, Dr. Andrew Taylor, still emphasized in his works, finding disease is fairly simple, but helping our patients find health, that is our true mission. No one is better prepared than you, and no one can do it better than you. Opportunities you have yet to dream await you to seize and realize. Our future is in your hands. Until we meet again, congratulations and Godspeed.